Welcome to Evening Prayers on Wednesday the 16th of November 2022. We start with a prayer from Julian of Norwich. Let us pray. Through your love, O Lord, all your works have begun. By your love you sustain them, and in your love our life is everlasting. So let the beginning and ending of all our loving be to see you, O God, for ever and ever. Amen. Our reading today is from Deuteronomy, again, chapter 6 this time, and verses 4 to 13.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your foreheads. Write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates. When the Lord your God brings you into the land he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give you, a land with large, flourishing cities you did not build, houses filled with all kinds of good things you did not provide, wells you did not dig, and vineyards and olive groves you did not plant, then when you eat and are satisfied, be careful that you do not forget the Lord who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. Fear the Lord your God. Serve him only, and take your oaths in his name.
In yesterday's reading, we heard Moses place God's love at the centre of his relationship with his people, the Israelites. Now we hear Moses emphasising what the people's response to that love should be. Love for God with every part of themselves, heart, soul, and strength, total commitment and loyalty to the King of all creation. Moses says to the people that they should constantly be aware of this truth, talking about it, wearing it, seeing it around them everywhere. It is absolutely central to a good and right relationship with God. We know that the Jews remembered this instruction because it crops up in the Gospels. When the teachers of the law asked Jesus what was the greatest commandment, he replied with this very statement, adding that the second, from Leviticus 19 verse 8, is to love your neighbour as yourself. And Jesus, at the start of the parable of the Good Samaritan, challenges the questioner to state what the law requires in order to inherit eternal life, to which the reply is the same two commandments. Learning and repeating truths is so important, but we do need to be careful in our repetition, not just to trot out the words, but to really focus on the meaning. But our love for God needs to be deeper than just repeating words. It needs to be part of who we are, our very being. Jesus, through his death and resurrection, has brought in the new covenant of God with all of his people on earth. The covenant that Jeremiah spoke of when he said that God would write his laws on our hearts. God living in us through his Holy Spirit is the seal of this promise. Moses goes on to warn the people not to forget the Lord when they got settled, more comfortable, and life was easier. We have seen that happen in our affluent society when our dependence on God has been lost because we can do things ourselves. Thank you very much. So this evening, let us reaffirm our love for God, a love of commitment and loyalty, a love responding to his gifts of forgiveness, hope, peace and joy through our Saviour Jesus Christ, a love written deep within our hearts. God with us. Let us pray. Lord God, we want to offer our love to you, a love which comes from you, for you are our loving parent, a love with which we offer our commitment to you. Forgive us, Lord, when we allow our love for you to cool, when we rely on our own strengths and abilities and neglect our relationship with you. Forgive us when we fail to love those around us as we should, or fail to love ourselves. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, we pray for those who need to know your love at this time, for those living in fear for their lives or those of loved ones, fear of what the future might bring, fear of loneliness or illness, fear of dying. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the dispossessed, the refugees and asylum seekers, for the persecuted and the oppressed, for those forgotten or ignored by society. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are hungry or thirsty, for those who haven't the basic requirements for life, for those who don't know how they are going to make ends meet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those in positions of power and responsibility, that they may act with integrity, justice, compassion and fairness, seeking to serve rather than exert power. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And from our Methodist prayer handbook, today we remember those in the churches in Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Pakistan, and for the Methodist Church in Ireland. And we pray for ourselves, that we may know more of your love in our lives and be able to show and share with those we meet and live with. Lord God, give us peace and rest in the assurance of your grace and love. And we say together the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And we finish with Tim Hughes's song, Everything, as we offer our whole lives to God as a response to his love. See you tomorrow.
God in my heart.